everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm Biebs Kelly. Thank you so much for being here with me. Today, we are taking a look back at a few of Meghan Markle's outfits that I have never covered before. I hope you don't mind my more casual outfit today. I didn't think I was gonna have a chance to film, but I did. So I popped right on in a hurry. Let's kick things off with this picture. There's a blue dress she wore in a now iconic photograph with the rain coming down. I have to admit, credit where credit's due, this is a great photograph. The rain and the sparkle and the backlight that somehow was present. It does look like a beautiful setting with that soft focused background and everything. So it's a great picture, but the outfit itself is not so great. And it's a good illustration of why wearing things that are too tight just doesn't fit in these types of scenarios and settings. But let's start off with a few positives. I really like this color. It's one of my favorite colors of blue, so I love this color in general, but it also looks fabulous on her. This is a good color choice for her in general. She actually looks really good in bright colors especially, but you know, she has gravitated farther and farther away from bright colors in the years after this picture was taken, rather than gravitating towards some of these more electric colors that were really beautiful, like the yellow dress that she wore way back when. I've talked about that dress being a really great choice for her body type. Brighter colors that she occasionally wore were great choices. I almost feel like I saw her in more color during her time with the royal family than after, so you know, looking back at these photos sometimes really brings those things to light because she's been wearing almost exclusively dull colors for the last few years. But back to the dress. I think that the makeup here is way over the top. This is an example of way too much at once. She has bright lipstick, very, very dark eyes, and contour, highlight, blush that is quite dark. And at this particular event, I don't believe she was giving a speech or anything like that. I think that they were just attending an event, and so there was no need for her to wear stage makeup, as it were. If you missed my video going over her makeup and her makeup mistakes, go check it out. I will link it for you because it explains really well how sometimes you might see someone like, for example, Catherine Princess of Wales, or occasionally Meghan Markle, in makeup that is slightly intense because they are giving a speech at that time and you do want more intense makeup for a speech. But she did not give a speech at this event, as far as I know. And even if she did, giving a speech in person is not the same as giving a speech to like a huge auditorium or some sort of show or being on film. So I don't see her needing this amount of heavy makeup. I think that this was a choice, and I think it was a bad choice. However, the hair, I do quite like a low ponytail. I feel like from the front, it's very elegant and slicked back, but you still have it down to some degree, and I think it looks quite nice. Although I'm not 100% behind it for this occasion necessarily, I think that because it was taking place in the evening and they were attending something in a professional capacity, that perhaps just swinging it into a bun or a slightly looser style would have been maybe a little bit more flattering. This is an excellent illustration of one of the ways that this dress is too tight, is right along that waistband area. You can see that the skirt portion is folding up and creeping upwards. So it's sort of coming up over the top of where the waistband seam is. And this is something that really only will happen if your garment is too tight. This could be caused by the dress being too tight in the hips and thighs, in the waistband, or both. But in a dress or skirt situation that is fitted properly, you will not have it riding up and bunching up. It's just not supposed to happen. Your garment should hang nicely and stay put. The top portion I also feel like is not fitted exactly properly. As you can see, there is some weird puckering and bunching in the armpits, and you can see the outline of where her bra is, and this should never be happening. I find this in her outfits time and time again, where there is bunching and puckering in the pits and too tight across the bust. So I firmly believe that she wears a different bra for fittings than she does for outings. From a styling perspective, whether you choose to wear padded bras or not to enhance your bust size, no matter, you do need to wear the same bra for your fittings or buy based on the size you are with the bra you plan on wearing as you're gonna wear for the actual event. You have to have the same bra and the same measurements. And make no mistake, a padded bra can enhance your bust size up to 2 cup sizes. So that is a huge difference and would cause these types of problems. On the bright side, I think that this neckline is a great choice. Simple round necklines like this that are nice and clean can be really, really flattering for somebody with her body type, but so can V-necks, which will elongate this area. But this is also a good option, especially since she's not super busty, because if you're really busty, the higher necklines can be quite tricky because they just make this upper body area look super duper long and out of proportion. But for her, this is a really nice choice. I also like the sleeves here. I think that having some degree of sleeve is very flattering to her as compared to like halter tops and strapless. Those we've seen enough of. If you missed it, she wore another halter top at Invictus and that video will be linked here. So I do appreciate the fact that she has sleeves here. However, it's clearly chilly. I don't remember what time of year this was exactly, but the people standing outside all have at least long sleeves, if not jackets, coats, raincoats. Nobody else is there in a t-shirt, and I get she's just walking from the car into the place. But this is an example of what I talk about when I say dressing for the occasion and not sticking out like a sore thumb and not making yourself stand out in a bad way. And since you will be being photographed, that matters. Now, does it matter in our regular day-to-day lives? No. Would it matter if this was a personal capacity moment? No. If we saw her just walking from her car into like the gym and she didn't put on a coat, nobody would care. Since they were there in a professional capacity on official duties, you are gonna be photographed. These images are what run in the media, so you don't want to do something that doesn't make sense simply for that reason. And because it just gives people something to talk about other than the actual issues. Because we pick up on that whether we notice it at first or not, we automatically pick up on it, and it's automatically a bit off-putting because it's like, why is this one person doing something different than everybody else? Because we know, our rational mind knows, that a whole entire group cannot all be wrong and one person be right in these types of situations. She should have thrown on a coat. Perhaps like a double-breasted coachman jacket or something like that would have been a nice choice. Back to the dress itself. You can also tell that it's too tight because around the legs it's pulling, and we know she takes ginormous steps, but in this particular picture you can see she's not taking extremely large steps and it's still pulling a lot on the skirt, so it's just simply too tight. One thing I do like about this dress and skirt situation is that it hits below the knee, which is a really great option for her. Hitting right at or just below the knee is going to minimize the twigginess of her legs. Another thing we see here is just how tight it is when she sits down. So anytime you're trying on a garment, whether it's a dress or a skirt or jeans or a top, anything, you do need to sit down. It seems like common sense that everybody should know, but clearly not everybody knows, because you can see just how tight this is. You can see every bulge and lump, and it's not a good look. It just doesn't look flattering. And she's quite thin. It doesn't matter how skinny you are. If your garment is too tight and you sit down, it looks bad. The last thing I have to say about this outfit is that I wish she would have done this ponytail look with a side part. She looks a lot better in a side part, and this photograph is a great example of that. That just illustrates how much nicer she looks when she's got a side part, because this just looks too severe. It's not for everybody. It's not my best friend either. Let's take a moment to thank today's sponsor, Factor. Factor makes meeting your nutrition goals easier than ever before by delivering dietitian-approved, fresh, never frozen meals straight to your door. Are you too busy to cook this fall but still want to make sure that you're eating well? With Factor, you can skip the extra trips to the grocery store, the washing and chopping and prepping, even the cleanup, while still getting the flavor and nutritional quality you need. You get to choose from over 34 flavor-packed weekly meal options, and it's as easy as selecting the meals that you want and then waiting for Factor to deliver it straight to you, ready in just 2 minutes. You can also round out your meal and replenish your snack supply with an assortment of over 45 add-ons, including breakfast items, or for an easy wellness boost, try their beverages, like shakes, smoothies, or these cold-pressed juices I tried. This one is the apple beet ginger, and it's absolutely delicious. It's so nice to be able to have something that's like this nutritious, quick and ready to go to help you get that boost that you need. So head on over to factor75.com or click the link below and use code KELLY50 for 50% off your first Factor box. Don't forget to click the link below or head on over to factor75.com and use code KELLY50 to get 50% off your first Factor box. Thank you so much to Factor for sponsoring today's video. But moving on, we have this outfit, which I have never talked about. I'm not sure why, perhaps because at the same time Catherine, Princess of Wales, blew the red pantsuit out of the water with her gorgeous Alexander McQueen pantsuit that was just to die for. It was absolutely fabulous, and she re-wore it during the coronation concert, so she clearly likes it too, and it is one of her best looks, I think, that red suit is. So it was way better, millions of miles better, than this. But regardless, let's take a deeper look at this. I will say, first off, the best part about this outfit is the encouragement of a vertical line. She's still quite a bit taller than me, but she benefits from elongating her figure in large part because she has such a short torso in proportion to the rest of her body. Her limbs are long and her torso is shorter and boxier, so by encouraging vertical lines in her outfits, particularly in the upper body, really helps to elongate her figure, elongate her torso specifically, and create a little bit better balance in her outfit. So that part of it's really good. However, just taking a look at this outfit as a whole, the first things that you notice are the boxiness of her torso and the width of her shoulder line. Part of that is because she was on stage and whatnot, so the red outfit is really bright and contrasting to the environment, which is mostly dark behind her. I know this outfit caused a big stir online, as well as this pose. It's just kind of a ridiculous pose for a picture. People didn't like the finger holding, and I can agree, it looks quite awkward and strange. So many parts of their messaging come across as juvenile, including the finger holding here. The outfit itself unfortunately betrayed her because it widened her overall, and it didn't look very flattering in the pants, the legs. She clearly did not have this pantsuit tailored for her because, like, this image from behind, it just looks awful. She didn't have on the proper undergarment. In a situation like this where you have a top that's blousey like this and you're tucking it into pants or a skirt, what you need to do is get some shapewear shorts and tuck your top into the shapewear shorts and then put your bottoms on. If you don't, then you get this where you have what appears to be the bunching and wrinkling of the shirt that's supposed to be tucked in underneath that just looks really bad. Part of what makes this outfit not work is also the higher neck, and the scarf around here is just creating a lot of visual noise around her neck, which needs to be elongated, not suffocated and stuffed up with extra fabric here. And then in contrast, it made it look like her shoulders were even more wide simply because of the design of the shirt. I will say, however, the pants are clearly not super duper high rise. It looks like they're falling down a little bit. It looks like they were perhaps a size too big or a half size too big, and she should have just had them taken in a little bit because there's just a lot of room happening here around the rise. So around the crotch area, it looks to be like they're like sagging a bit. So pull up your pants, then they're gonna be a little too high and make your torso look too short in this sort of a situation. So for her, the answer would have been for the pants to be the right size. But the fact that they were not completely high rise is a good thing. Here is a picture of what the outfit is supposed to look like. Clearly the model is quite tall and has a more narrow frame than Meghan Markle does, but even still, this is showing you what it's supposed to look like, how it's supposed to be styled. And it's just not quite the same. It looks like the rise on the pants on the model is even lower, and that the trousers are obviously designed to be worn well-fitted and more slim fit. So something is really off about her pants here. They look to be too big. And also the model had the scarf pulled away from the neck a little bit so that it doesn't have that sort of restrictive look to it. The way that Meghan Markle wore it, it looks very much like it's pulling against her throat. I don't particularly care for the choice of shoes here. I feel like something with a slightly chunkier heel would have been much more appropriate, or even a boot. When you are wearing long trouser pants like this, that's when you can get away with something a little bit more comfortable and wearable. And this just gave a bit of an odd look. And unfortunately, it just enhanced the very long lanky limbs and the wider boxier torso. This outfit just didn't do her the favors that I think she maybe thought it would. It also appears quite wrinkly, but I think they were sitting for quite a while before she got up to give her speech. So I would imagine some of the wrinkling is from that, and we would have to be understanding to it. Though I'm sure most of us can agree she probably arrived with a fair bit of wrinkles. Next up, we have this one. Now, I have covered this outfit before, but that video is quite old and like a little bit lower quality than this one, so we're gonna do this one again. I believe this is a top, and the reason why I believe this is meant to just be a strapless top is because of Sofia Vergara right here. She is wearing what looks to be the exact same top as a top, not a dress. So it's not a dress. I originally thought this was a dress because of how she wore it with the black underneath and the belt across the center, but it's looking like it's actually just a top. And this is a great illustration of how important it is to dress for your body type. Strapless tops like this, especially those with some structure to them the way this top has, are best suited to ladies with a little curve, particularly hourglass type ladies. The way Sofia Vergara has it worn here, it looks so much more flattering on her than it does on Meghan. Looks like she might not have that weird strap. That weird strap on Meghan Markle doesn't even look like it's attached properly. It looks all askew. Rumor has it that Harry told her, "You can't wear something strapless to this event, darling." And she put a bra strap on as a halter strap situation to make it not strapless, which would be super weird. That's the moment where you choose a different outfit, not the moment where you do something weird and juvenile like put a bra strap on to call the dress not strapless. Like, I don't even understand. I don't know 100% if that's true or not, but that's the rumor, and if that's true, that's pretty bad. But here on Meghan Markle, I want to make it clear, this was November in London. If you've ever been in England in November, I'm sure you can attest to the fact that something strapless is not quite warm enough. And it doesn't make a whole lot of sense, and it made her stick out like a sore thumb. Literally, any of the pictures from inside the venue, she looks super weird next to people in warmer options. And even walking in, the people behind her are all in like raincoats and winter coats, and clearly dressed for cold weather. So what she was doing in something strapless is beyond me. It must have been embarrassing for Harry, especially at this stage, because I think this was pretty early on. So she and Harry hadn't been together all that long at this point, and he was bringing her out with probably high hopes that things were gonna go really great and smoothly, and it just didn't. And this was an embarrassing choice. It looked horrible. It didn't go with her body type at all. And it was just the wrong choice for like 1,000 reasons. So the one and only Invictus outfit from this year that I have not covered yet is this one, in which she was reading aloud to kids and she was wearing yet another neutral outfit. First thing that's bothering me is this weird piece of hair just bloop hanging out of the top of her chignon bun. Her hair would have looked really, really nice if it weren't for that happening. Not sure how that got away from the hairstylist, but it looks bad. This outfit itself, I couldn't find any full-length pictures of it, so I'm not sure what exactly is happening with the rise of the pants or how they look overall. But I will say that if she's wearing cropped or capri pants, that is a really big improvement, you guys. It's much better choice than shorts, and it still provides that casual air that shorts do without looking unprofessional or unflattering. Now, of course, capri or cropped pants are not going to be quite as professional as full-length pants, but this is a much better option than shorts, 100%. She was reading to a hand-picked group of children from Rosie Revere Engineer, but it sounds a little bit boring to me. I go to story times all the time, and you have to be commanding and engaging to get those kids to sit still and listen. And you can tell that some of the bigger kids are doing what they're supposed to do, but you can see some of the toddlers or the younger ones are like, man, let's get out of here. This is boring. I'm not sure I have a lot of confidence in her story time delivery being very engaging and exciting for little ones to listen to, but I could be wrong. But this would certainly have been an occasion to wear perhaps a brightly colored top or a fun jacket that was cute and bright and colorful to spruce things up a little bit. Maybe even some fun earrings for the little ones to look at or comment on, like, oh, like maybe like butterflies or ladybugs or something like that. Kids notice those little details and think that you're more approachable when you have something more whimsical on. And brighter colors is, of course, cheerful and would have been perfect in a setting like this. Something a little bit more casual than this trench would have been nice. What do you guys think? If you missed the rest of her looks from Invictus, I will be sure to link the videos up here. There are two of them. I agree 100% with those of you who said she should have just worn Invictus Games gear. She should have. It's true. A polo, a long sleeve, a short sleeve, even a sweatshirt from Invictus, worn with some basic trousers and jeans and some trainers or even just flats, like plain black flats, the whole time would have been perfect. It would have given nobody anything to say about what she wore or how much it cost or who's paying for it if Invictus had to pay for her wardrobe. It would have given no thought to any of that and kept the attention on the games because she wasn't wearing anything noteworthy or distracting. But instead, she wore some of the most distracting things, some really inappropriate choices, especially when working with servicemen, and she just looked distracting in a bad way. It would have been very fitting and won her some brownie points with the public if she would have just worn the Invictus gear the whole time. I agree completely. Well, that is it for today's video, you guys. Thank you so much for being here with me. I will see you in the next video. Have a happy day, everybody. Bye!